Well, here I will show you how to place in additional fresh air blower or outdoor air duct. Typically, all office space will have its own outdoor air requirement. Here in the space schedule, based on the cooling load calculation we have done previously, the outdoor air flow specified is 20 liters, 30, 20, 20. So all in all, it's about 130 liters per second. So we will be putting the outdoor air from this area. From this side, we'll place a grill outdoor and then place a fan, small fan, pump the air into the office space and duct it into this, dump it inside the ceiling space. So we need 20 liters, that will be a small duct, which is about 100 by 100 or 150 by 100 duct for each piece of spaces, and the total airflow is 130 liters per second. So let's go in back to our duct sizing calculator. So 130, unfortunately that this rabbit doesn't have the duct sizing calculator, so let's size it 130. So it's about, using the round rectangular duct, it's about 200 by 200 duct, let's say at 65. So we need a 200 by 200. Let's lay it out first. Let's go to system. In the duct sizer, now select the rectangular duct. Here you won't find any for fresh air type system type, so we have to create another system part. So how do we do that? Let's go to the families, expand the families if you have it. Flaps, here expand it, and let's go to the duct system. Here select, as we are going to pump the air into this room, it is a type of a supply air, but we need to duplicate here and select type properties. Here we can rename this to fresh air or outdoor air. Okay, now let's change the color. Let's duplicate it so we don't accidentally change the other colors from the air conditioning tab. Let's set it as FA, and let's set the folder to let's name it a cyan. Okay, let's set the appearance to cyan color. This is cyan, I think. Click OK, apply, click OK. So now here in the abbreviation, let's key in FAD for fresh air duct. Okay. And visibility graphic, let's set it to cyan also, so we have the same color as the graphics. Okay. Okay. We have accidentally changed this part, so this is we have done is we have changed this to cyan. This is the duct system. So we have a fresh air supply air is defined. Let's go to type properties. SADB. Oh, we have accidentally changed SADB to cyan. So let's change it back to blue. Like, and click apply and click OK. So the we need to change this fresh air. Let's set the type properties. Okay, we have a cyan, and let's set it. We have changed it. Oh, this is the we have incorrectly changed the color. Click apply and click OK. Ah, sorry. I think we are using same type of material, so let's go to type properties again. Cyan, we have duplicate the SAD, or we have replaced the SAD with blue. Let's see the SA. SAW. Now let's change it back to. We have made this mistake. Then we duplicate it and set it as FA. Cyan. When we have changed it, we also. Let's give it this. We have already one. So let's unselect this. Let's go to FAD. So we're also, because of the same material, so let's get another material. Let's set it's paint. Let's use the correct one. Let's paint and let's rename this to duplicate to FAD plus cyan 1. We're going to delete later the other cyan call as other cyan color materials that we provided. Let's go to cyan. Okay, use reference, apply now. We have separated the color for the fresh air and the supply air. You may encounter these issues once you are still a beginner, but as long as you know how to chase it back to your preference, you can do it. Here we're going to create the duct system. We're going to run the duct chilling board again. So let's set the 130, it's 200 by 200, and let's say 65, it's about 150 by 150. So let's render these two, 200 by 200 and 150. It means that we're going to take the fresh air from here and distribute it to the office air. So let's set the duct. We're going to use a rectangular duct. Let's set the middle elevation to about 3450, which is higher than the supply air duct, so we don't clash with any of the sources. Then the duct is 200 by 200, and let's make sure this is under pressure. Click apply, and let's set the duct works first. Run it here. Here. Then from once we have distributed this tree, we can reduce it to 150 by 150. Apply and then send it here. One duct here can actually go inside the room. And another duct we can just actually branch it up and go to this inside the room. So it will supply the air from this guy into inside the air. So here we can also do it here and dump some air using a 150 by 150 duct. Or actually we can still reduce it to 100 by 100, but we'll just maintain the 150 by 150 for now. And let's not forget we will also run on this air. Now to control the airflow and balance it, we need to place some duct accessory, which is the volume control duct. If we don't have it here, let's go to system. Let's insert some of the family. Also, the family, as we do not have the volume control duct, air side dampener, duct accessories. Let's go to that and let's go to accessories, dampers, and let's set the control damper, manual rectangular control damper. Click open and let's place it here. One. It will automatically adapt to the system if it's connected. So you can control the quantity of fresh air inside the loop. You can see that you can easily identify which is the fresh air bag and the supply air bag. So basically, you can go to 3D, we call that one bag. That accessory. Let's go to 3D. Here we have the fresh air bag. Let's go back to level 1. Now we need to take in the air from this side and then install a fan here to pump in the air going into the individual unit, because the length of the dipole is quite long and it cannot be sucked by the fan coil unit using the natural displacement. So we need to insert a fan here. So let's go to the mechanical. We need to insert a small fan. Let's select one inline fan, so we don't have. Let's insert load quality. Let's go to documents. I have my own quality here created. I have a small fan. Let's say small cabinet fan, inline fan. Let's go inline fan, because the capacity is quite small. So let's make sure this height is 3450, same level. So we can insert it here. And we can connect from this back to this. It will automatically create its own connection. Then the duct will have to get the pressure from outside the room. So let's go to the system. Duct. Let's maintain the 200 by 200 ducts. In this height, and this is also we have done the system incorrectly. We should still follow the system, so let's set the pressure and duct it outside. Once outside, we can increase the duct size to 400 by 200 to make for the connection of the louver or outside here. So the air will go here and then inside. Now let's connect here to this guy. Now we have a fan to suck in and boost the air pressure and push the air into inside the office fan. So this is the fresh air system which we have created, which is also a requirement in the ACM design, especially in office fan. Here how it looks like. So this is how we create the air conditioning, a fresh air duct system for this area.